Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the CAW All Stars Hall of Fame Induction Ceremony. Please welcome the host of CAW All Stars, Sean Walsh.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, welcome to the CAW All Stars Hall of Fame. I've always wanted the Hall of Fame to be a part of CAW All Stars, and there's no better time than the week of CAW All Stars 10 to start things off. Tonight, it's about honoring the legends of this business. So let's not waste any more time. Let's get the induction ceremony underway. To kick things off, the founder and owner of FOW, and now Hall of Famer, James Thomas. Tonight, we honor the life and legacy of James Thomas, colleague, by inducting him into the CAW All Stars Hall of Fame. James Thomas was a big contributor to the very first CAW All Stars back in 2009. He united different sides of the CAW wrestling worlds from top to bottom. Tonight, we remember his contributions to CAW wrestling, as he and FOW will never be forgotten. I feel it eating in me. Will you still drag?
Thank you.
James Thomas is finally where he belongs, in the Hall of Fame. I will proudly accept this honor on his behalf. The memories will never die, as they won't for our next inductee as well, a man who I'm very proud will be joining us this evening to accept this honor. A man who defines a Hall of Famer. Whether it's the good or the bad, the DWF has been at the forefront here in CAW Wrestling. DWF has influenced many of us here in CAW All Stars, has influenced myself, DZW's AJ Young, CCL's Eddie Mack, and so many more. The DWF was one of the first promotions to cross-promote and trade talent, as they did in 2008 with Extreme CAW Wrestling with TGO and Tank. Now look how far we've come. It's with great pleasure that I introduce to you the owner of the Dynasty Wrestling franchise and now CAW All Stars Hall of Famer, DJ Wentworth.
For those of you who do not know who I am, my name is Daryl James Wentworth, also known as DJ Wentworth, also known as the guy who created the time skip, but most importantly, also known as the creator and founder of the Dynasty Wrestling franchise. July 26, 2006, I created a channel named ADJ Eagles 76. You can tell I was a Philadelphia fan. Wow. I created that channel, made maybe one or two videos, music videos with Dragon Ball Z, with music that immediately got flagged in the years to come, which made those videos kind of disappear from the world forever. But I was also a huge fan of professional wrestling, and I was also creating characters ever since WrestleMania 2000. I created so many characters that had kind of a weird and profound impact on a lot of people, more than I thought. Guys like the Great One, TGO, the American Eagle, JT Money, the Rebel, Sir Magic, ACP, Zippa Man, and many more. A lot of characters with their own lore and have lives outside of my channel, and it was amazing. If I could just tell a quick story here, I had a plan all 2007, create each and every single character, write out storylines, and then release DWF WrestleMania 2007 on my birthday, December 21st. Oddly enough, I felt pressure, because in September of that year, Extreme CAW Wrestling started off their trailer, and then by November, they were already putting up episodes, and their show was similar to mine, and my style and everything like that, which pressured me to start putting out videos a lot sooner than I initially wanted to. And if it wasn't for Extreme CAW Wrestling doing that, I don't think I would have ever gotten the push to put DWF up, because I was always wishy-washy. There's a couple of episodes called DWF Heat that never made it to air, and I recently found those DVDs. Wow. Okay. I found out where I got the name Marcus Steele from. That was from that was from that. Man, but anything. Anyway, I would like to shout out Extreme Call Wrestling, because throughout my entire process, they were the standard bearers, and they were a measuring stick for me to head towards. And believe it or not, I made some enemies very fast. And the craziest thing is I can't thank them enough. First off, there were a couple of videos from a guy wearing a cane mask that was threatening me and threatening my life and everything like that. And I think it was because I wasn't making videos or anything like that. He went by the name Miss You Mossy, you know, was part of 6699, which was a interesting group. However, I kind of turned the negative into a positive, and I ended up making him a character. He was one of the biggest heels my show ever had in MY Mossy. So oddly enough, I have to thank him. He gave me a super monster heel, which was amazing. And I would be remiss if I did not thank the ultimate YouTube bad guy. He ended up on the show as Bully Nate, but NMC017, you know, there was definitely a war of words there, but, you know, in all honesty, I really loved every moment of it. You gotta remember, sometimes I would say things just to generate a reaction. Most of the time, I'm not what I seem like, okay? I'm actually a theater geek in real life, and I'm just a punk-ass bitch. So, I'll say anything just to generate a response, and he was the same way. And us going back and forth was a lot of fun back in 2008. So, Nate Carter, thank you very much. Another company that I want to thank is a company that took TGO and made him a huge star outside of DWF, and that was Full Throttle Wrestling, FTW. Their last show had their biggest star, KJ Johnson, and my biggest star, TGO, shake hands. And that's how their company ended, which was freaking amazing. And I always had this notion to bring KJ Johnson into DWF as a tribute to them, but it just never really materialized. So with that being said, thank you, Johnny Applebaum, and thank you, FTWCAW. Of course, I'm going to thank Sean Walsh. With this entire event, this whole thing, this shit is epic. This is what I wanted my WrestleManias to be like. You've succeeded where I failed. This is going to be amazing, you know. I'm looking forward to how this whole thing unfolds. I also want to thank Call Champions League. They took a couple of my characters, actually, and made them great, actually. Booked them better than I ever could, which made me jealous and made me want to come back, so that's great. So yeah, Eddie Mack, you are amazing. Maybe I'll come back if conspiracy happens again, but I know how much of a pain that was. Also, a big up to Gold-007. You know, URWL, that's a show that I could never comprehend rivaling, having my show rival, you know. Yeah, like the way he presented his show was amazing, and I know it took a lot of hard work and everything like that. There was even one point in time I was trying to campaign for Keller to end up on his show, just to see what he would do with the next gen game. But, you know, things happen, I guess. But hopefully he's doing well. Thank you for being yet another inspiration to me. You know, I sit here and I think to myself, WWE 2K14 was quintessential for DWF. That's the game for me. When the new system started and everything started looking more realistic, you gotta realize I'm a bit of a control freak. I don't like how the system looked, you know, or felt in my hands, because I would control every character, you know. A little inside baseball there, but it was very interesting to kind of go through that, to say the least. And I will admit, WWE 2K18, I created a couple of people. I created TGO, ACP, Sir Magic. I created Leonidas Gonzalez. I created H. Bane. I created Hollister Cross. I created about 40 superstars. But then reality hit. Those who don't know, I'm 30 years old. I have other aspirations that I want to pursue on YouTube. You may have noticed that I even tried to make DWF Wrestling into something like What Culture or Cultaholic or something like that. And I did one video and then I said to myself, this is whack. And I stopped. So I do sit here, and there is a part of me that wants to do DWF, wants to create DWF, especially on 2K18 or 2K19. But here's the reality. I don't want to do DWF alone anymore. If I'm being completely and absolutely transparent with you guys, which I promised myself I would do tonight, I have other aspirations. You know, I'm working on music now. I'm filming a movie right now. Real life, you know. There was even a moment where I trained to be a pro wrestling referee. And, it's a couple of different things, man. So it's really hard for me to kind of sit there and dedicate all these hours to DWF and everything like that, when honestly the only thing I could really do at this point is provide the storyline, and just providing the script, the storyline, and being able to do commentary. Barely do commentary. I don't even know if I'd be able to do that, to tell you the truth. But you know, with DWF, there's a huge part of me that wants it to continue, because I have an entire year written out for DWF, Raw, SmackDown, NXT, you name it, I have it, you know. But it's just it's not even the want to, it's the time, the timing to do this. Hell, I'll break kayfabe right now. Sean told me about this induction months ago, and you know, I had all this time to prepare a speech and get this together. But right now, I'm going off the top of my head, I'm going off the cusp, because I'm actually sending this in last minute, because I just moved and I just had 6 days on set for a film and all these different things happening, you know. And it's been a lot, you know. As much as I have a passion for professional wrestling and as much of a desire I have to be a storyteller in wrestling, even for call wrestling, I have to be honest, like, this DWF is something I can't do on my own. Which leads me to a big announcement that I wanted to make. Yeah. So, for the Dynasty Wrestling franchise, the only way I would continue creating DWF is if I had a team behind me. Listen, I always had trouble working with people, but I like to think that I've grown from then, you know. A lot of people actually mature over the years. That's something that even today's society can't understand when they dig up a person's Twitter and judge a 24-year-old for a 13-year-old's tweet. But people mature, people change. Like I said before, I was a huge control freak about DWF, you know. Always had trouble taking other people's suggestions and ideas because it usually led to them trying to put their character in the show and make their character the world champ and everything like that, which, you know, not how it works. You know? So here's what I'm going to propose. If there's anyone listening to this that feels like they could contribute to DWF coming back, contact me. Contact me. Figure out a way to contact me. You know, I'm not going to make it easy. Figure out a way to contact me, okay? Because if we could make DWF a collaboration with the current roster and the current stars on there, then I think DWF could become something amazing once again. You know, ECW, I'll shout them out one more time. They're going into a new realm. They're switching finally to 2K17 or 2K18, you know? And I commend them for that, because I'm scared to do that on my own, you know? Maybe for DWF, there can be life. But I have to admit that I can't do it alone. That's why I wanted to kind of speak to the car wrestling world in general and all the fans of the Dynasty Wrestling franchise, all the haters of the Dynasty Wrestling franchise, and everyone in between. Thank you. Thank you for everything. Thank you for keeping DWF alive for as long as you have. You've done more for DWF than the WWE games have with their glitches. I can't thank you enough for the support. I sit here remembering when I recorded the very first match for DWF WrestleMania 2007. It was a 6-man Money in the Bank ladder match that featured Benny Hall, ACP, and the eventual winner, the next-gen game, Keller. I remember that day, recording it on a big-ass tube TV from the 80s, using cheap video capture software and editing it in Windows Movie Maker 2.6. That's how old school that was. I didn't think that I'd be sitting here in 2018 being recognized for all that I did in call wrestling, good and the bad. Like I said, I created the time skip. I'm sorry about that. So hopefully I stand here and hopefully, you know, DWF will find life. Because at this point, there are two options here for the Dynasty Wrestling franchise. Option A is that this is the last time you will ever hear from me, and DWF will be dead and gone forever. Kind of sad, right? But as I've admitted, I can't do this on my own anymore. Option B is that through the car wrestling community, there could be some people that could help create the characters, help create logos, help film the matches, help do the commentary, allow me to do the scripting, because the scripting is the easiest part for me at this point. And then we can create DWF together. And we can work together and work on our craft and bring exciting call wrestling to YouTube again. Not that there isn't exciting call wrestling on YouTube right now. I mean, for love of God, AWF 105 is a channel to check out, you know? I still watch. I still do. In between works and in between jobs and in between gigs, I'll pop on and I might watch, I might watch some old UWO stuff or whatever, you know, or Call of Honor, you know, or Wildcats or the DCA, you know. I'll just watch because it's entertainment, you know. Shouldn't be ashamed to be a call wrestling fan. Okay, I think I've rambled enough here. But I just want to say thank you so much for acknowledging my existence. Call wrestling was an outlet for me when I felt alone, when I felt isolated, when I didn't like myself. And it helped me grow out of that shell, getting reactions and getting recognized by each and every single one of you. Thank you. Goodbye.
A certain superstar has decided to cash in his money in the bank. Keller.
You have got to be kidding me! I thought he left the pedigree to ACP! Oh my God! We have a new DWF champion!
The sharpshooter, again! Will Kilgore be able to get out of it this time? And oh my God, Kilgore's tapping! Kilgore has tapped out! Here at WrestleMania 3, the Rebel has come to WrestleMania to become the DWF Champion! And now, oh my God, another RKO. And oh no, JT Money kept up, bounce check on the steps, and it's all over. JT Money has done it.
Thank you to DJ Wentworth. And I can't speak for anyone else, although I'm sure there are quite a few who will express the same thing I'm about to express. Although I have quite a busy schedule here with CAW All Stars and the AWF and amongst other responsibilities, in even of the smallest of ways that I could help out to a possible revival the Dynasty Wrestling franchise, I would love to contribute. Now, as we continue on with the event, it's now time for a polarizing figure to take his rightful place in the Hall of Fame. Although maybe it was never envisioned how far he'd go. He made it this far, so he deserves this recognition. He will forever be remembered as the first ever CAW All Stars champion. And to this day, after as we are approaching our 10th CAW All Stars event, is still the longest reigning CAW All Stars champion. If that isn't a Hall of Famer, then I don't know what is. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look back at the memories of the new Hall of Famer, Quicksilver. He was matched to crown the first ever CAW All Stars champion. So you put six guys, you put them in the Elimination Chamber. Seems the right way to crown a champion. Quicksilver did win the CAW All Stars championship, as we all do know today.
So we ended up with Quicksilver winning with an arm drag, which we rolled with, and it became the arm drag of death.
Mustard.
Especially that neck. He's holding his head. That's a slam by Quicksilver. Now, is he going for the pin?
Oh no.
Two.
Huh?
Three.
What?
Quicksilver is the winner.
No. He scooped him down. Well, isn't that annoying?
Yeah, tell me about it.
That was the most annoying ending I've ever seen.
Well, Blackheart did push you out. He was defeated, so.
Shut up. Like, Quicksilver, we hope you watch this event. This has been Bob Bobinson and Extreme Nan. We'll see you later for more CAW All Stars.
Alright.
The arm drag of death. One of the all-star legends of CAW All Stars.
So yeah, the first CAW All Stars title was won by arm drag. Yeah.
Quicksilver started his CAW career a part of DIW, where he won the Dungeon Championship, which he renamed the Silver Star Championship. He went on and joined GCW, becoming GCW World Heavyweight Champion. But at the top of his resume is being the first ever CAW All-Stars Champion.
Quicksilver! He is the first ever CAW All-Stars champion. He held that championship all the way to CAW All-Stars 4.
Quicksilver, arguably one of the greatest CAW All-Stars champions there were.
He successfully retained his championship at CAW All-Stars 2, 3, and twice at 4 before losing on a cash-in to Lubu. He returned to CAW All-Stars at CAW All-Stars 6 and brought back the original championship title.
Quicksilver is coming out with the old CAW All-Stars title here.
What? Are you surprised? Are you surprised I'm holding this championship? My championship, the championship I held for 4 years.
He went on to compete for the CAW All-Stars championship in the main event of CAW All-Stars 7 against fellow former champions AJ Young and CJ Hawkins. He even busted out the old arm drag of death. Tonight, Quicksilver can add Hall of Famer to his impressive resume. Our next inductee may be a little bit controversial to some due to the evolution of CAW Wrestling. Fantasy CAW Wrestling is certainly an acquired taste. Some that some people just don't have. But even if those who don't, all have to admit, is a pinnacle in this industry. And it continues to be a very important part of it. And when you look back at some of the greatest in fantasy CAW Wrestling, at the top of that list, at least in my mind and in the minds of many, is Spiderman. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we have a video prepared as we look back at the career of Spiderman here in CAW Wrestling. Give it up for the now Hall of Famer.
And now,
making his entrance, Spider-Man. He is the webmaster. He is the underdog of No DQ CAW.
Known to the world as Marvel's friendly neighborhood hero, is one of CAW Wrestling's first legends. Spider-Man was a key member of one of CAW's first CAW shows on
NoDQ.com.
Spider-Man started his CAW legacy in NoDQ CAW and even won the NoDQ CAW Championship in 2004.
He is now the new champion!
But perhaps best known for his contributions to SCAW, as Spider-Man was the first ever SCAW champion. Spider-Man is also known for creating big moments, such as the moment he turned his back on the fans to form the NoDQ World Order.
Wait, what the? Wait, that's a... It's like a frog splash! And wait, that crap! Doesn't realize that there's a switch! What? He got the ping! What? The leader? He's gonna reveal his identity? Let's go out. Who is he? Who is he? What? 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 Oh my god! That's Spider-Man! Oh my god! Spider-Man! Spider-Man apparently is the leader of the NWO!
But no moment was bigger than when he returned to the red and blue before Blood, Sweat, and Tears 3.
Right. We could be looking at the next SCW champion. We could be looking at a man who'll be a three-time champion. Wait, what the? That can't be. What the? Wait, what the? Ah! That can't be! What the? Spider-Man! Spider-Man! It's Spider-Man! What the? He's back in the race! We thought we'd never see this again! Hey! I thought they need to go down! Oh my... No, wait! He's not gonna... He's set for five-star Spider... Spike! Oh my god! Spider-Man! He's back! I don't know if... This maybe changes everything!
Spider-Man went on to win the SCAW Championship at Blood, Sweat, and Tears 3.
He's got the title! Ichigo's still down! Spider-Man's got the title!
Championship that he has now held a total of 6 times, the most in SCAW history. Spider-Man has even competed at CAW All Stars, at CAW All Stars 8 against UCCW's own Dominator, in which we saw a one-night reunion of the NWO.
A steel chair.
Yes. Oh, no.
Wait, what?
Wait a second.
Wait a damn second.
I think someone just called for some backup.
No way.
I haven't seen it in years.
There's no way. This is not happening, folks.
Is stopped in his tracks.
So is the rest of the Bullet Club.
The Bullet Club have all gotten in the ring. Here they are.
Oh my god.
Michael Myers is back.
Mr. Cleese, Jack Sparrow, it's Anthony Hughes.
Spider-Man still competes to this very day and will even be a part of the CAW All Stars 10 Legends Battle Royal. But tonight, we celebrate everything he has done and everything he will continue to do. And here we are, at the end of the night, with only one more inductee to take his rightful place in the CAW All Stars Hall of Fame. This man was demanded amongst all of you, the fans, to take his place in the Hall of Fame. The second that the Hall of Fame was announced, his name was the constant. No matter who was announced, the people waited, and they demanded that the doctor be a Hall of Famer. And as the people should, now I knew from the beginning that the doctor would be in the Hall of Fame. But it was nice to see how much respect that the man has, that the fans demanded his induction. And we are going to deliver what the fans want. We're going to give them the doctor in the Hall of Fame. But before we bring him out here, I have a few words. Whether you know the doctor from the DWA, CCL, COH, as the commentator or the leader of the Doctor's Order, which is resurrected again in CCL in perhaps its most dominant form. The Doctor may be the voice of many different shows. He may be the advocate for many different Mega CAW superstars. But the greatest thing to come from the doctor's whole time here in CAW Wrestling, for me, is none of that, but it's what takes place behind the scenes. I was very fortunate to become friends with Doc. I remember him, like many of you, watching old DWA shows and hearing him and watching the Doctor's Order. Never did I envision that I could be getting into Skype calls or having regular contact with him. And we've been through a lot, and he has had my back throughout all of the tough times that come with this. I appreciate that so much. I want to stress that because tonight we're not just inducting the CAW commentator, the CAW manager, the doctor. No, we're also inducting the man behind the character. Because he's done so much for this industry. And his reach, he has reached out to so many different people and been an incredible help in any way that he could. And that is something that we should all aspire to be. Now, I could go on and on and on and talk about all the great things the doctor has done. I could talk about a lot of great stories that a lot of you don't know. But that wouldn't be fair, would it, for me to do that? I think there is one man who could do it better than I. Perhaps I'm not the right scorpion to do the job. Perhaps there's a southern scorpion who could do this justice. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the man who had asked to induct the doctor into the Hall of Fame, the Raging Redneck, Ray Geddes.
Huh. You know, most of the time people hear me, I'm pissed off. But that's not the case tonight. That's not the case at all. Because it's not every day a good friend of mine is inducted into the CAW All Stars Hall of Fame. I'm actually happy and beaming with pride. So you're not going to hear me threaten to whip the hell out of somebody, or put my size 14 boot to somebody's ass, or even call them a stupid sumbitch. Well, not unless they're acting like one. But back to the man being inducted tonight, the Dr. Gary Lockard. I could talk about so many things with him. I could talk about all of his accolades he accomplished through his years in this business. I could talk about Doc the Wrestler. Doc being the single greatest manager in the history of CAW, or even one of the greatest commentators. There's so many things I could talk about, because he's done it all. He's been around. He's done everything you can do in this industry. But I want to talk about just a small piece of everything I mentioned. Doc the Performer. From the first time I met Doc in CAW Champions League, we hit it off immediately. We had this unbelievable chemistry. Whether we were standing side by side, on the same side, or on the opposite sides of each other, we just clicked together, and people loved it. We knew what each other was going to do and sort of fed off of each other's energy, especially when it came to the comedy aspect of things. I'll never forget the Concur promo. Do you concur, Doctor? I concur. It still makes me laugh. You drank all the damn whiskey that night. That one solidified and exhibited that chemistry firsthand, though. And it just flowed from there, whenever we were together to perform for an audience. The truth is, I could tell you about several more just like that. Or I could talk directly to my good friend, without getting all sappy, because that sure as hell ain't my style. You're a man I respect, a man I'm gonna miss. You're one of the best to ever set foot in this industry. A man of 1,000 jokes and puns, the leader of the Doctor's Order. Now get your ass out here, Doc, and accept your place as an icon in this business.
Thank you, Ray, for that lovely induction speech. I tell you, it has been an absolute pleasure getting to know Ray on both a business and personal level here. And he was probably my first friend when I came back to CAW. Eddie brought me back at CCL. And when Ray and I started talking and looking together, he's probably my first friend when I came back to CAW. So I'm always gonna talk to Ray. I'm always gonna know Ray and just kind of pal out with Ray. Hall of Fame. God. Some of the things you kids are doing today are truly innovative, and I'd like to tell you that the things that Party Man are doing are just top of the line, and if I can figure out how to do it with a straight face, I'll get back to you. So, I'm not going to take a whole lot of your time, because it's been a hell of a night. It's going to be a great night still to come. But I do want to tell you all one thing. You all have so many more advantages today than I did 10 years ago, 15, however long I've been doing this. Sean Walsh can tell you. I certainly can't. I've made new friends, Jay, Carol, Sean, Travis, Eddie, Champ, Brian, and the list goes on. Brandon Wolf. Talk about a guy, actually, man, I've already mentioned Ray, Johnny Thunder. You know, a lot of these guys I've met in real life, you know. Obviously, Big B, Brandon, Johnny. You know, you all have one advantage, though, that I didn't. When I first started with Brandon in DWA, I didn't know of the broad spectrum of CAW. I've said it on the Sean Wall Show. I've said it on other various platforms. I didn't know that there were so many. I truly did not. I think I knew of one other one. I've previously been on the record, but of saying that there were no others that I knew of, but I think I knew of SCAW, and that was it. You guys know each other. You guys connect a lot better than we all did, than I did, certainly, back in the day. And you guys, if you put your minds to it, you all can do just about anything. This may be my Hall of Fame induction, but it is truly everybody that got me into this, from Eddie welcoming me back to CCL to, you know, the fans getting me, starting a petition of sorts. I still have not seen this damn thing, but starting a petition of sorts to get me in CCL and COH. So this truly does belong to everybody. And from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank each and every one of you guys. You guys all had the potential to be Hall of Famers, and you truly do. It's putting in the work, being creative, being inventive, and putting in the passion that will truly drive you to success in something as simple as a hobby online. And if you apply that to your day-to-day, like I have, there's no limit to what you can do. And I'm here to tell you that as well, because I've got a pretty great life. So if you take it from something as simple as this and apply it to your real life, guys, the sky truly is the limit. Thank you all. Everybody have a great night. Enjoy this wonderful show, and we'll see y'all. I'm still in CCL and a few other places, and I'll see you guys here and there. I'm sure I'll pop in. Love you guys. You guys are awesome. Message me anytime about anything. Good night, everybody.